Hey there, we are in the middle of a storm. And this is my son Matthew, who is turning 21 tomorrow.
I am. I also didn't fix my hair or anything before this video. It's up.
Yep, so when I come back, we have an epic unboxing to do from my good buddy, James. So James Hayes Jr., this video is definitely for you. And I peeked and looked. I'm excited. We're going to talk about these. And we'll be right back. Hey there, so Captain Sirius over there.
Hey.
So right now we are looking at the box that I got from James Hayes Jr. and ready to take the first thing out, Matthew?
Oh, absolutely. This is the big one.
Nice, I love this one. Collect Slasher Classics Collection. So James had a extra box, and I'm glad he did because when I got the stuff from 88 Films, one of the cases was cracked all the way down here.
Geez.
So this is going to take the place and actually make my Slasher Classics collection.
Gotta say.
Complete.
Love the red case. I've always, like, funny thing, but I've always loved the colored cases of, like, well, initially Blu-rays when they first came out, and I was like, oh, cool, blue cases, that makes sense. And then, like, I remember the video game for Hulk.
The green one.
Yeah, it had the green one.
All Destruction, right?
Mm-hmm. So about, not All Destruction. I think it was actually the Incredible Hulk, the movie game. But that was, one was still okay, but it had a really cool case. Either way, I've always liked colored cases, so it's cool.
So, I want to get the, there's a poster in here. I want to get this. And a letter. Oh, letter, you hold this first.
Yeah.
So, here are the movies we were talking about. I knew they're not new, but they're like, you only play once. It does not matter. These are awesome things. I really want them. I also included one new Arrow Blu-ray, and I remember you mentioned in a video that you wanted to upgrade this movie to Blue. Ray one day, and I know how much you like your Arrow releases. Take care, James. I love my Arrow releases. We'll be doing a video after this one of a new Arrow release that I got. Cast is over in the back. You want to open up the poster?
What's that? Absolutely. Very nice.
So we got Ripley. Want to put that up closer? That is cool. That was going up. You got to get framed. I love those things. I love posters. Harvey wants to... Should I leave the Arrow for last?
Yeah.
I'll leave the blue stuff.
That was the surprise one.
I'll leave the surprises for last. I want to keep the thing. So, originally James knew that I'm in an Italian mood. I actually said I was going to be buying mostly European videos for the first part of this year. That's what I'm going to do my collecting right now. A lot of Region 2 stuff.
Oh, speaking of European cases. Stuff.
Yeah, exactly. Have you seen these?
I didn't look at the cases.
So, first off, we have the classic Zombie Holocaust. You ever seen this movie?
I've not.
You will.
Totally. Show me the back.
He's the gross stuff got you. Great. So, this one is extremely cool. Ian McCulloch from Zombie, I think, is in this one. Yeah, one guy's from that.
Yeah.
It's kind of like a zombie movie, cannibal style movie. And when I say cannibal, yes, zombies eat people, so that's where the whole camp thing can come in. But cannibalistic films tend to be gorier than some of the zombie films. But so it's got the cool yellow case. I really love this case. And the really cool thing about this is that the feature on this got named like one of the best like documentary features. Was like got big acclaim. That's called Eaten Alive. It's basically about the whole like cannibal documentary cannibal movie craze. So. Can I show the back? Let me see. No, I think there's nudity in the back, so I can't show the back. But here you go. Zombie Holocaust, part of the 88 Films Cult Cinema Classic Collection. I really love these here. I love the fact that they have this, like, kind of look for use the way the cases are done.
Sure.
Next up is...
Yeah, that was nudity.
What Quentin Tarantino called Lamberto Bava's best film. Blast Fighter. Blast Fighter is part action movie, part deliverance... Part Last House on the Left. It's an unusual film. And I love these type of films. You would love this type of film. So, you got a guy that's a Vietnam vet, missing a found missing daughter, a hilarious action sequence. George Eastman's in this one here, and I love everything George Eastman's in. This is its UK debut, Blast Fighter by Lamberto Bava. I'm just really excited to have this release. I wanted this for so long. I'm looking at, I'll show you a trailer afterwards. It is such a unique trailer. It's like, did I ever show a trailer of Deadly Pride? It's kind of like that.
I don't think so.
So the next up is a Giallo, and I love Giallos. You too love Giallos.
Yeah, I do.
And this one here is
what I thought the whole yellow was about, but
is Spasmo. Spasmo. There's a company that does yellow things that are all
Giallo. Yeah, because I was like, oh, yellow, like it must be Giallo. And then I looked, and I was like, well, that's not a Giallo. Neither's that one.
Well, this one is a Giallo, and it stars Susie Kendall from Torso. You saw Torso.
Yep.
But she's a star of Torso as well.
Oh.
I love the just the kind of the plain like look that these have. It just suits it so well, and it's just very cool. Again, I love the way these look here. Spasmo, again, another classic one. Giallo, that I've not seen in ages. This one we should definitely watch tonight.
Yeah.
And another Giallo.
Oh, look at that.
And it's the Lamberto Bava as well.
I was half right about these being Giallos.
Yeah, half right you were. A Blade in the Dark. I love these films. I used to have this, I think I still may have, a double feature that had Blade in the Dark and Macabre. Two really, really kind of quirky, different Bava films. But I don't think I've ever really watched all of this one, and I really want to. This one also stars Michel Soave. I hope I got that right. Soave. I don't know. Rico Soave. And it's that's the guy who did the movie Stage Fright, the one with the owl mask.
Oh, okay.
And he was also the silver mask person in the movie Demons that's passing out the tickets.
Oh.
He became a great director in his own right. So, thank you so much. I was so excited when you told me that these were coming. You have no idea. I wanted to buy some 80 films recently. The shipping was astronomical, unfortunately. It's kind of ironic that the Giallo Spasmo actually has the lowest rating.
Yeah.
Freaky, eh? But Blade in the Dark. Mm. So, next up is a Twilight Time and an Arrow Video. Twilight Time. Twilight Time is a big, it's a hard company. I can't get them around here without, it's a fortune for me here in Canada. It's like somewhere in the range of $50 to $80 for one of their films, unfortunately. but thanks to James, I was able to get this one that I really, really wanted. I'm so excited. Strange Invaders. This is a really cool 80s, like, kind of like throwback type of like, monstery film, and as always, there's just like a little booklet here, and it'll always have the original poster art on the back.
Interesting inside art, I gotta say.
Yeah, it is, isn't it? I love the face. Spoiler alert! But the inside art, yeah, Matt, it's great. I totally have to show this. So this is the disc, and this is the inside art, which is actually pretty cool. It's a fun alien feature, and this makes my 8th Twilight Time edition that I got, and I love every one that I've gotten so far. I'm addicted to these things. These are amazing. Strange Invaders. See that one?
Yep.
Totally see that one. Like aliens ripping off faces and stuff like
that. That sounds cool. It sounds really cool.
It is pretty cool. And next up is one that that helps complete like my early trilogy collection. I've got Texas Chainsaw Massacre, like the special edition on the other side. You can't see it right there now.
Gotta say, this kind of bookends things for what we started with.
It does, doesn't it?
Yeah.
I got the Life Force. I got Funhouse. And I got a few by Tobe Hooper. But this was the one that I was missing the Blu-ray of. I had the old Dark Sky edition. But I really wanted to upgrade this one to Blu-ray. And thank you. This is my Cinema Sickness, if you watch his videos, and you kind of should, because he has some really great stuff. Has this thing called Cinnamon. So I'm going to have to name my opener here. So I don't have a name for it yet, so maybe I'll make that like a, something you guys can do or something like that. For fun, or maybe one of these days I'll make a contest out of it. Got another video kind of right after this, where we're going to be talking about one of mine and Matthew's actually favorite Giallo, Deep Red. So it is Eaten Alive. I love this freaking movie. It is so underrated. People do not give this the credit that it deserves. This is a really good one. And his name is Buck. And he likes to play parts. Jeez. Sorry, guys. I can't. But anyway, because I was recently told, before they don't put my... This is gorgeous art. This is the one that cracked the alligator, like, kind of eating people.
Okay.
Like, the guy kills people and then he feeds an alligator. It's by the guy, of course, the Texas Chainsaw Massacre. I'm going to hold it there for a second in case you want to, like... So feature-wise, what does it have? Well, everything that the Dark Sky one had, plus much more. We have a new brand new 2K restoration on here, optional English subtitles for the deaf and hard of hearing. Audio commentary, a new introduction by Hooper, a Blood on the Bayou, a brand new interview with Hooper, Gator Bait, a brand new interview with the star Janice Blythe, Monsters and Metaphors, a brand new interview with makeup artist Craig Reardon, the Gator Creator, an archive interview with Hooper, My Name is Buck, an archive interview with Robert Englund, 5 minutes with Marilyn Burns, Texas Chainsaw star, discusses her role in Eaten Alive, The Butcher of Elmendorf, The Legend of Joe Ball, featurette looking at the true story of the Southern Texas bar owner on whom Eaten Alive is loosely based, theatrical trailers for the movie under various titles including Eaten Alive, Death Trap, Starlight, Slaughter, and Horror Hotel, TV and radio spots, alternate openings, behind-the-scenes slideshow, stills and promo galleries, audience comment cards, reversible sleeve featuring original and newly commissioned artwork by Gary Pullen, and of course, as always, the collector's booklet. And it's good to have this one while there's still collection booklet. So, who is that? That's Noah Brand.
Okay.
He was like a big Western star back in the day. So, I'll open it up here. I want to see if... So here's isn't with the poster, Horror Hotel. You check in alive, but check out dead. What's that?
You don't check out then, I guess.
Yeah, you kind of don't. Poor, and Marilyn Burns always gets the worst of it. But this is an amazingly great film. It's way, way underrated. If you have not seen this film, you really should. So I'm going to show you what the other art looks like now. So inside, you got this one here. Best little horror house in Texas. Get it? And the original artwork, which is actually pretty cool. Eat the monster and his friend. It actually makes it hard to know which artwork to put on because they are both really great artwork. So, I came home to this today. I was super excited. Which one of these would you watch first, Matthew?
Probably one of the Giallos.
Are you sure it wouldn't be Cannibal Holocaust? Not Cannibal Holocaust. Okay. Zombie Holocaust?
Probably.
I am, isn't it?
I was having some trouble myself when I was watching Tales from the Dark Side earlier. That was my thing.
So, Eaten Alive from Arrow Video, one of my favorite companies that you guys all know from up there. Twilight Time, Strange Invaders. I'm so excited to finally have this movie. You would not believe it. A Blade in the Dark, Lamberto Bava, goodness. Spasmo, classic Giallo goodness. Same as the Blade in the Dark, actually. Blast Fighter. Yeah. Blast Fighter. That's the thing we should watch. We should watch Blast Fighter and like the other one. Pain. The awesome, cool Pain. Mm-hmm. And Zombie Holocaust. A classic. Classic. With eye gouging done just for you.
No,
and of course, I'm about to fix my slasher video collection. Thank you, James, so much. Extremely appreciate this. It is awesome. It's an awesome way to start our my son's birthday weekend.
Yeah.
He's actually here, and we're having the whole birthday weekend type thing. Cass is over practicing her piano, and me and Matt are here on a show and things together.
Oh, yeah. I don't know, my Vita and stuff like that. So this, which I'm going to have to look through and probably get a game on in a second.
It's really cool. Fetus. Anyway, I'm not sure if Cathode Ray is going on tonight or not, but I know that I think we are doing, there was one coming up soon, and we are maybe having somebody new in Cathode Ray. So watch out for that. Thanks for watching, guys. I've got so much goodness, and I have one more package to show you in my next video. Thanks for watching.